Today, we'd like to share with you the beauty of our culture. Now, I'd like to introduce myself first. My name is Wurundjeri, which means the full moon. I am a Jagadgai or Kudjalanji woman. My house is located North Queensland on the East Coast. Now, I'd like to explain the first part we just performed. During the ceremony, all of our people across Australia perform. First one is the smoking ceremony. It's a cleansing process. As you know, that's one of the days that came out with the smoke. It was cleansing the area, yourself and all of us. That house takes away all the negative energy, bad spirit. But it's also inviting the positive energy, the good spirit, so we can enjoy our ceremony. With the smoking ceremony was a song and dance called Wurundjeri or Wurundjeri. That one has my home in North Queensland, as the mother's people, Jagadgai, located in the Cairns. It's quite a special place that we go to for ceremony. Build a fire, add gum leaves to create smoke. The smoke will cleanse the land, the air, and the people. After that, we did a welcome song and dance coming from one of the brothers' country, west of Brisbane, Manajali. It's called Jalama. Now, it's about the Manajali people going out into the bush. They're making all sorts of noise. They're singing, clapping, chanting. That's to let everyone know that ceremony is about to begin. The way was to welcome everyone over to be part of it. Before we continue on, we must always respect Aboriginal laws and protocols. Now, the first law we follow every day, every show that we perform, and that is paying our respects and acknowledgement to the traditional owners of the Blue Mountain area. All together, we are the land of the Ngunnawal and the Darug Nation. Now, there is Ngunnawal's tribal totem. In their language, they call Bijiwa, which is the water dragon. Now, we follow that law because all of us who are here today, we're all from different Aboriginal countries across Australia. But all the colours you see on Australia, mate, they represent all the Aboriginal countries. We all spoke different languages. There's over 300 of them. Now, we will learn our main language from our country. Then, traditionally growing up, we must also learn the languages of our neighbouring countries. Because we share ceremonies, songs and dances, and stories, that way all of our people connecting, coming as one. Now, Australia has different regions, which we'd like to show you. Within these regions, our people would practice their lifestyles in many different ways. For example, hunting method is different, how they made their tools and weapons, bush medicine, bush tuckers in those areas. What was also different around Australia with our people was our skin tones and also appearance. Now, a lot of people have that stereotypical idea that all Aboriginal people should be really dark, big foreheads, wide nose, and so on. But when you travel around Australia, you're going to find Aboriginal people many different skin colours and also features. Now, this happened before settlement, but it caused a bit huge impact after. And this is due to the fact Australia being a multicultural society today. So many of our people have mixed with other race, say interracial marriage, children, and so on. So some of us happen to have a bit of mix. But to us, it doesn't make us any less of anything. A good example of that is myself. I am Aboriginal. I'm also a Torres Strait Islander. They're known to be the second Indigenous people to Australia. And I also have a bit of Irish in me as well. Now, before settlement, our people still have many different skin colours because of different environments they lived in. For example, you go to the desert countries, you're going to find Aboriginal people out there. Their skin tones be a lot darker because they're exposed to the sun a lot more and have a lighter shade. You go to areas like the Snowy Mountains, you find Aboriginal people's skin tones a lot lighter because they have that lack of sunlight and they cover up a lot more, protecting themselves from the cold weather. Now, one more difference I'd like to share with you is the different styles of art we have. Now, in these regions. Now, our art is what we call our laws. Now, these laws can represent, for example, our stories, ceremonies, be about our country, songs and dance, even maps to waterholes. Although we've seen all these differences we have across Australia, we are all still connected, especially our stories. We share the same values and beliefs. We believe we're equal to every living thing that Mother Earth has provided. Down to the smallest part like dirt, water, especially all of our animals and plants, because they're our life source. We also have a very strong kinship that we all share. That is, always respecting Mother Earth and God for everything they've provided for our people for thousands and thousands. We also respect the spirits, because they are ancestors. the old people that walked before us. They were the ones that handed down the culture, our laws, our knowledge. Now, the next one I'd like to share with you is a very old traditional story. The story has been handed down through each generation.